Whereas the 930 is having the Snapdragon 800 chipset, which is again higher in terms of specification as compared to these two. So this one has a faster processor, whereas these two have the same kind of processor. Although the things are different in these two phones as well, we have the build quality difference, which is the major difference in between these three phones. So we can see that we have plastic being used over here on the 730, which is a plastic back cover which holds the complete phone together. We have 6.7 megapixel camera at the back with LED flash. We do have secondary microphone for noise cancellation and video chat. We have the loudspeaker over there, and we have plastic which is being used on the back cover, which again can be removed in the case of 730. When it comes to 830 has a plastic back cover which can also be removed, but it has a kind of a metal frame which actually holds the complete phone together. So it is much more solid as compared to the build quality we see on the 730, which is kind of a plastic phone as far as build quality goes. So this one is definitely not something which we normally expect coming from Nokia or from Microsoft. So again, 830 is going to slightly cost you more, but this will also give you a very good build quality, a very strong feel as well. In terms of the weight, I can compare the weight of these two. This is going to weigh approximately 150 gram, whereas this one is around 130 gram. So this is 20 grams heavier as compared to 730, but again, it has a very good strong metal frame, which actually holds the complete phone together. And again, it has a very good build quality, much stronger build quality as compared to 730. When we talk about the camera, we have 10 megapixel camera, which is powered with PureView technology. And we have Carl Zeiss optics over there. We have Zeiss optics over there. When we talk about this device, we have the Nokia Lumia 930 with us. And this device has a 20 megapixel camera, which is higher as compared to these two. And this one has dual LED flash. This one has four microphones for proper video recording with noise cancellation, whereas this one has two microphones. This one also has two microphones. So audio recording is going to be a richer experience on 930. As far as build quality goes, this is going to be the best in terms of build quality as well as in terms of the premiumness. So again, if you compare the 830 with the 930 over there, you can see the difference that the metal actually is there on the edges on both of these two phones. But when we talk about the build quality is good enough on both of them, but the overall premiumness, the overall look and feel is definitely better on the Nokia Lumia 930 as compared to 830. 830 also looks good, but again, this device may not look as premium as we have seen on the 930. Again, both of these devices have 5-inch display, but in terms of the width, you can easily notice the difference that 830 is slightly bigger in terms of the height, and it is also slightly bigger in terms of the width as well, which you can easily notice. So width is more on 830 and the height is also more. So this is going to be a bigger phone even when you have the same 5-inch display form factor on this device, with thinner bezels and thinner upper and bottom part, which actually makes this device better to hold in one hand. The overall look and feel of these two devices will remain the same. Again, these two devices are inspired from the design which we have seen on the Nokia Lumia 925 earlier, but these devices have got flat edges unlike the rounded edges which we have seen on Nokia 925, which was launched last year. So in terms of the camera, definitely this device is better in terms of the camera as compared to 830, but this device is also better in terms of the camera from the front as well. We have a 0.9 megapixel camera, which is the lowest in the case of 830, whereas we have 5 megapixel camera on this device, which is the best camera you can actually have as far as front camera is concerned. So in case you want to take selfie shots, you can take much better selfie shots on this device as compared to these two devices, and this is only for the front camera. So in terms of front camera, this is going to be coming on the first position, this is going to come on the second position, and this is going to be on the third position. As far as rear camera is concerned, the rear camera quality on this device is also very good. However, the quality is slightly better, and you have more options over here on the 10 megapixel camera on the 830, whereas this device has the best camera and it can give you much better photos and much better effects on the photos with the 930 as compared to these two. So camera wise, this is going to be a better device, especially from the rear camera department. Front camera is definitely best on this one, but this device goes on third position when it comes to the front camera. The overall look and feel, you can see the difference. You can compare these, I can compare these phones by holding them together. You can see it from the edges. The edges are again plastic buttons, plastic edges there on this device, whereas metallic edges are there, metallic buttons are there, metallic edge is there, and metallic buttons are there. So these two devices have metallic buttons and metallic edges, which gives you a very good premium feel when you hold these devices in one hand. And also you get a very good build quality, a very strong design. So because these phones might feel slightly heavier as compared to Lumia 730 in comparison, but these phones actually provide you a very strong build quality. So in case you drop these two phones, nothing should happen to these two phones because they have better build quality, but something might happen to this phone. Again, the plastic cover may come out, As far as connectivity goes, this is the dual SIM phone which we have with us for the 730. So 730 is a dual SIM phone. The back cover can be removed like this, and once you remove the back cover, you can see the battery. So battery on this device is a 2200 milliampere hour battery. On this device, on the 830, we have the 2200 milliampere hour battery again, although the dimensions are slightly different, but we have dual SIM supported on this device. So this is a dual SIM phone. 730 is a dual SIM phone, whereas the 830 is a single SIM phone, and it will accept only a nano SIM. We do have micro SD card supported as well on this device for the storage, so you can expand the storage of this device with the help of a micro SD memory card. Whereas on 930 we have limited storage of 32 GB, which is going to be the model which you will get. You cannot remove the back cover in this case, you cannot take the battery out, whereas you can do the same on these two phones. So battery can come out on these two phones, but this is a single SIM phone, this is a dual SIM phone, and this phone in terms of connectivity is also single SIM phone. And both 830 as well as 930 accept a nano SIM, not a normal size SIM card, not a micro SIM, it has to be a nano SIM. One thing which is better on the 830 is that you have the option to expand the storage, whereas you do not get the option to expand the storage in the case of 930. And we do have NFC supported on this device. NFC is there on these two, and wireless charging is supported on these two as well. Wireless charging on this device is something which I'm not sure whether it is supported or not, but it should be there. We will confirm that later. You do have the option to do a wireless display from any of these three devices. So all these three devices support wireless display, and we do have a wireless accessory coming from Microsoft, which will come for approximately 5,999, and it will be available by October 15, which you can buy. So in case you would like to project the display from these devices to other external monitor, you can do that. So in all, I can compare these phones on the basis of build quality. Build quality is the best on this one. Second goes to this, and third goes to this. This is again a plastic phone, so again, not that great in terms of the build quality. In terms of the front camera, this is going to be at the first position, this is going to be at the second position, and this is going to be on the third position. In terms of the overall form factor and the weight, I can say that this device is slightly heavy as compared to these two, which again makes it slightly heavy, but it also feels stronger. So it feels stronger, and it feels stronger so that if you drop it as well, nothing will happen to this phone, because it has a strong build quality as well when it feels stronger. Whereas on this device also have a very good build quality, but it feels slightly better in terms of the build quality, especially in terms of the build quality and the weight. If I want to give a balanced rating, I would say this is going to be the best device, because this has a great build quality and it is lighter in terms of the weight as compared to 930. When it comes to 730, 730 is definitely lighter in terms of the weight, but again, the build quality is not that great. Talking about the rear camera is going to be the best on this one. It is going to be pretty good on this one, and it is going to be pretty decent on this one as well. So this is how the position will be. This is going to be on the first on the rear camera department, this is going to be on the second, and this is going to be on the third position. Talking about the loudspeaker quality, I can say that the loudspeaker is fairly loud on this device, and this device, the 830, actually have the loudest loudspeaker. We have just tested the loudspeaker on all these three phones, and this device has the loudest loudspeaker as compared to 730, as compared to 930. 930 is going to be on the second position, and 730 is going to be on the third position when it comes to the speaker loudness. But this device has the loudest loudspeaker. So in case you would like to select these three phones, the kind of value for money you can get is going to be on the 730. However, you will need to compromise on certain things. One is the display size. The display size on this device is a 4.7-inch display, whereas this is 5-inch display, and 930 is 5-inch display again. So display size will go for a compromise. Another thing which will go for a compromise is that you will have touch capacitive buttons not within the body of the phone, but within the display. So this is another compromise which they have actually done to make the device cost less. On the production, they have actually done that. The display capacitive buttons, the touch capacitive buttons, are actually there within the display. They are not on the body of the phone, unlike these two phones. So again, whenever these touch capacitive buttons are there within the body of the phone, it becomes easier to access them, it becomes easier to use them. When it comes to another compromise which has been there on these three devices, or the major compromise which is there on this one, is the dedicated camera shutter key. We do have dedicated camera shutter key on the 930 as well as on the 830, but we do not have that on the 730. And this is another compromise which they have actually done. When it comes to the battery does not go for a compromise. This device has a 2200 milliampere hour battery, which is good enough. One thing which is good about the 730, even when it is cheaper as compared to the 830 and 930, is that it has a Super AMOLED display. So this device has a Super AMOLED display, which is brighter, which is better in terms of color production as compared to the display, the IPS LCD display which we have on 830. And the camera quality is also pretty decent on this device. And again, whenever you take photos on this device, this device display will actually always look much brighter, much colorful as compared to 830, and you can easily notice it. And the viewing angles are also better. I can say that the viewing angles are slightly better on the 730 as compared to 830 as of now. And if you compare it with the 930, I can show you the difference. So So 930 is also good enough in terms of the color production, and I think both of these displays are almost the same kind of displays. I'm not sure whether the 930 is a Super AMOLED one or not, but this is also giving a very good viewing angle, and the color production on both of these two displays are better as compared to this one. So these are the differences, these are the key differences which I wanted to point out in between all these three devices on the basis of build quality, on the basis of form factor, on the basis of display size. One more thing I would like to tell you is that this device will come for 32 GB of storage. This one does not have SD card support, but it has around 23 GB available to the user, whereas the 730 will come with 8 GB of storage. It will give you approximately 6.5 GB available to the user. You do have SD card support on this device. On 830 we have approximately 16 GB of storage, out of which you will get 13 GB available to the user, and you do have SD card supported on this device as well. So in terms of storage, these two devices wins the race because they do have support for expandable storage. So you can insert a micro SD card, you can install applications on micro SD memory card, but you cannot do that on 930. So this is going to be a compromise, but this device will come with 32 GB variant, so it will give you fairly good amount of storage on board. You don't have to actually use the micro SD memory card unless you are a power user. So that's all from us as far as the key differences in between these three phones, the 730, 830 and 930. And all I would like to say is that in case you are looking for a premium phone, you can go for the 930. In case you want a premium hardware, a premium look and feel, a premium build quality, you can go for the 930. In case you would like to go for something in middle as far as build quality goes, you can go for the 830. You will have a decent camera, you will have a decent front camera as well. Front camera is again slightly compromised on this one as compared to these two. So front camera performance is not that good, but build quality is good enough and the hardware is also good enough. Whereas if you want to have a better front camera and a better value for money device, you can always go for 730, which will give you a better value for your money, which you invest in any of the which you invest in 730. So 730 is a better value for money at 15,000 rupees, whereas it has the same hardware which is there on 830. So hardware remains the same, the cameras are different, there is a slight difference on the storage, there is a slight difference on the display size. These are the major differences. Again, let me know if you have any questions for any of these three devices. We would love to help you. Thanks for watching this video. You can leave your questions in the comment section below. In case this video helped you, you can always like this video by clicking the like button below. You can subscribe to our YouTube video channel for more videos like this by clicking the subscribe button below. Thanks for watching this video. This is Abhishek signing off. Thank you.